Bomber Boys, World War II flight jacket art. B-17 radio operator Larry Goldstein, on the day he got his jacket and the night they arrived at their barracks in England, in his own words.
They took us out to a hangar and they had lined up all tables of equipment. And as you went down the line, they gave you your flight equipment. We were so naive at the time. When we got towards the end of the line, we were given the A2 jacket, and boy, that was like being king of the hill. And they gave us a pair of Bosch and Lomb sunglasses. We had to try that stuff on when we got back to the barracks, and we were really airmen. We hadn't seen an airplane yet. And we boarded the Queen Mary. 7 days later, we were in Scotland, sent to a small camp for a couple of days. And the next thing you know, we were on a train, an English train, and we arrived at our air base, the Nettleshall, that's K with a K, and it was the home of the 388th Bomb Group. We arrived there at night, and we were assigned to a barracks, and we walked into the barracks. There were six guys laying on their beds, and there were 24 empty beds. And we came in full of swagger, and somebody in our group said, "Where are the guys from the beds?" "Oh, they were all shot down the last few days." You could hear our egos crashing to the ground. In my diary, I wrote, "We unpacked in total silence."
Bomber Boys, World War II flight jacket art by John Slemp. The high-resolution photographs featuring over 100 jackets from all World War II theaters and from museums and private collections across the USA offer a glimpse into this seldom-seen genre of military folk art. The book is arguably the definitive source ever produced on this subject. For more information, visit worldwar2bomberboys.com.